waters, like otherwise you've got a waterfall of stairs and then a cap and band on those. Doesn't look the best. This is the guys I know. In the real world, you can't do this all the time. This is, if you're doing something a bit, you know, expensive or a friend, you're not going to be doing this subcontracting with $3 a meter. But we just want to show you how it's done. This is going to be a bit like Roof Peter guys. This is like three stages that we've done here because it'll take too long. Back on. So the first thing we do is mark up our bones. Now, we first need to find out where the bend of the nose starts. And we just marked it there with a bit of pen. And we get our carbon on. If you notice, we haven't forgotten to put the underlay on. We mark it out before the underlay goes on. The underlay goes on later, then it becomes tighter. I'm just going to make sure it's square. Again, we put some bladders in it, just to hold it in place. And then finally, we're going to mark up, or transfer that mark, where our stitching starts, to the back of the carpet. Then we find out where our stitching ends. This is quite important because if you start stitching past the point where it ends, you'll cut through your stitches and it will unravel. Then we find out, then you run the mark up around the nose, keeping the mark at 90 degrees. Because then when he stitches on that line, the stitches actually come over the nose. Not, so they're not too high. I don't want to have a waypoint. I want to be out of there, it's going to be in here. Just check that those marks on. Take it off. I'm just going to find out the length of the bone nose. Transfer that. Now I've seen people get to this stage and we just cut that there, cut that there, sew it together, I think it's lovely, don't put it on, it looks like a bag or something else. Yeah? Really important that you need to take up the difference between there, the top of the bone nose and the base of the bone nose. Just measure the difference. We know it's 15. I'm just going to measure that out. I'm just going to take out that wedge. Yeah? Which is that there, that extra piece of material. So that's all the bones marked up. What Ben's going to do, while I show you the stitching, he's going to prep it. Basically, if you're right-handed, you get comfortable. You have the tool. Yeah? And you start your stitching, before you start it, it's just there, and you're going gradually to your stitch line. right? You make sure that all the tufts push back through there. If you can see tufts there, you're going to have a gap on the other side, aren't you? Yeah? And then you're going in about 10 mil deep. And 10 mil apart. What we tend to do every couple of 3-4 stitches, we lock it off. Yeah, so that then holds that all in place. You're not going to worry about that thing in there. And just carry on pushing these through. Again, 10 down, 10 deep. Unlock it off. Yeah. As long as you stick to the rules, it really can't go wrong. You just gotta make sure that it's material element as well. Yeah? Get yourself something decent to start with another practice. Have a bit of cheap crap, you know what I mean? So what you should end up with, this is one that we put on yesterday because we got a bit excited last night and got to stitch it. And that is what it should look like when it's done. Your stitches are finished, you turn it inside out, put some latex in there and then let it set overnight. I will never do this on site. I'll take the donuts home, get them gathered, on the can, sort it up, and then I'll go back the next day. Because if I try and do it the same day, it's not going to be strong enough. You know? If you're charging, we put some blind grip across the nose, there, and down the step. And then we've hacksawed down to the full mat curve. If this, we're treating this as a wooden floor, tile floor, antique or whatever. But now, that could be an expansion gap there, couldn't it? It's laminate or wood. Yeah. So we've got 12 mil space under there now to get a nice neat finish. Yeah. We've also put a band of underlay on the riser. We've put another piece about 2 inch or inch and a half down there. Now this is a bit crucial, this piece, because if that's too long, you can overpack it and it'll look like it's doing that. Yeah? Easiest way to do it is if you put the underlay, if the underlay falls behind the seabed, it's in the right place. If you can't see the whole side of the seabed, then it's just great. Because we want to, what we've done is get that form so this is nice and snug on there. Three of these are my favourite. And we're just going to get that nice and neat down over the nose, tape it up, hold it all firmly in place, and then we get it on. Once we've done the bones, I'm going to show you how we go about joining the carpet. A couple of do's and don'ts. Are you doing anything over there? Again, the gaps are the same, exactly the same. We've got 2/3 of thickness around the perimeter. The base of it, again, is the perimeter. There's always been a staircase there. So that would be, because there's a join on the stairs there, that's 1.5 times the thickness. Where there's a straight runner stairs, the gap is twice the thickness of the carpet. just trimming that in. Nice and neat. Almost there. Now where we start on this, it's like I said earlier, we're going to start from the obstacle. And the obstacle is the nose of the step. That becomes point A. And it is crucial that this is in the right place when you start. If it's not, it's just not going to work. Those stitches need to be in an exact place where you've marked it. Number four, just over the top of the nose. Wait, come on then, hit on. Once he's got that in position, exactly the same as he did with the kite winder, he's going to get that rattle through there so you can start getting some tension on it without it moving. Right, so the first point is the nose. The first point to get on is the nose. Pulling it out and down, it's just like doing a hook when we're using the knee kicker on there, which is just so it goes down and then back onto the pins. Once we've got that in, I think he's just going to put a hook rabbit in there, just hold it in place while he stretches back. So once you've got this on, we're going to put a little bit of a temporary stretch across the whip. And then we check that that is in the right position, because we haven't cut anything in, so we can move it in any direction at this point. Little tap there. Hook on. And then we just check. If you see there now, that it's looking quite firm already, and there's no tension on that yet. The stitches are in the right place. So once you get to that stage, then you quickly go, yeah? So again, now it's a stretching pattern, it's the length before the width. We'll just get our back wall on, if you like, which was that there. Just running along. And you cannot get a kicker to work that way, yeah? So we do exactly the same we did with the tight winder, rattle. Through the carpet, round the back of the gripper, and get some tension across the front of the step. Now we've got A and B on it. Right, now we continue the stretching pattern. Again, length before the width.